Hi, boys and girls. We are going to begin looking at our next reading lesson, and it's all about reader's check for comprehension. Okay, so we're going to start by talking about the Tin Man from Wizard of Oz, and this is why. Do you remember the Tin Man from Wizard of Oz? Well, he was an interesting character. After he had stood still for a very long time, he tried to start moving and started to squeak a lot because he was rusty. So kind of think about that as ourselves as readers. Even though we have done a lot of setting ourselves up for success in our reading in the classroom and with our reading activities, I think some of us might still feel a little rusty coming out of the spring and through summer break, kind of like the Tin Man was feeling a little rusty. Okay, so comes to feeling rusty about understanding what we are reading. But it is just because we have been out of practice. Okay, and so we're feeling a little rusty. So we're going to work really hard to shake off that rust. So our learning target today is I want you to learn that good readers give themselves a comprehension check at the end of each chapter to make sure they are understanding what is happening with what they are reading. So these are three questions you would ask that we ask ourselves, but also, yes, you. One question we ask is, who is in this part? What happened? And three, does this fit with something that already happened? Or is it new? Okay, so readers understand a story by giving themselves a comprehension check. Yes, we do that with the books that are just right, are within reach for us, choose the books we choose that we love. But regardless of what we're reading, okay, we're going to work on giving ourselves a comprehension check. So with the three comprehension questions, no matter what book you are reading, stopping at the end of the chapter, you will read and you will be asking the three key comprehension questions. And this will help you stay on track with understanding what is going on in your story. We will have the chart, which you will see here in the classroom and on Seesaw, okay, for you to be able to use as you read tomorrow. Then we are going to read you a passage of Stone Fox and model this right now. So this is a great example of why we read those mentor texts, so we can bring those back into modeling in with our lessons. So boys and girls, you will see a teacher who will take us through the modeling of Stone Fox. She is going to model the three comprehension questions and how to stop, how to pause, and how to ask who is in this part, what happened, and does this fit with something that already happened, or is it new? And then you will do that in your own independent reading. So continue watching.